I'm an artist. My name is Surendran Nair. I did my schooling nearby my village. I joined for painting in 1975, and we were the first batch of students in that institution. Then after that, I went to Baroda in Gujarat for my postgraduation that I did in printmaking. Since then, I've been living there and working. Medium of choice is painting. I use oils and watercolors. Then I also do printmaking. It was a kind of a gradual growth. One has incorporated a lot of things from your early childhood, or the days of your growing up, or the days of when you were in the art school. So there are lots of memories you still have, and when you revisit, or when you come to this place, you tend to revisit those elements. What I paint is something called out from my own imaginary things. It's more to do with imagination, but it may have references, or the references could be something to do with some memory you may have had, some vague memory even. From those things, you build your images, your concerns or your ideas in a particular kind of a medium. For that, even if things from the real, you don't take it as it is. It has to go through a kind of a process within my own head, which is never clear. That's what I'm saying, and I like it that way. I don't know, it's beautiful, its space is awesome, and quite intimidating as well. I'm basically a studio painter. I produce things in my studio, and I'm quite comfortable with that. I never wanted to be bogged down by a particular kind of size, because as a student I felt that I was unable to work anything bigger than an imperial size, which irritated me to the hilt and started to work against it. So now I can handle quite a big space, as well as I also do works which are very small, maybe 1 inch by 1 inch to up to 9 feet by 23 feet is what I have done so far. Even drawings, small watercolors, small oil paintings, not only prints. I don't want to get intimidated by spaces. That's what I have to see, what I can do. That's what what Jitish was suggesting, about taking some of my images from the comfort of the gallery space into the public arena. So when you are taking your images or things, or your imagination out of your studio space, then you will have to rethink how to approach those things. So it could turn up as an adventure, like he himself, his curatorial note itself was saying about the adventures of the colonial adventure itself is what brought them here, changed a whole lot of things in our lives. So I was open to that. I was never close to any such ideas. But if it was on my own, maybe I would not have ventured into such things. I think so. I do think like a painter. I use certain elements of which is inspired by some of the performing arts. So my work has an element of the theater in it, or there is something theatrical. So when you talk about painting, there are different aspects to it. So one is the thematic, one is other one is formal, and how you approach these images, the kind of the tone of the address. The way you address each and every image itself, all this becomes important. So I think it's a complex thing. You know, the whole business of making a work of art, or you know, painting itself. You know, the kind of, you know, involvement, you know, you have regarding, you know, the image, and you know, how, you know, in your own imagination, how it deals with, you know, the reality outside. One, you know, tends to reinvent. I don't paint mythological figures. My interest is, you know, something else. So, you know, when you're involved with a particular figure or a particular image, that is what you are constantly dealing with. I'm also, you know, quite fond of, you know, films, then literature. These all have, you know, influenced me. And also, you know, our traditional sculptures, more than painting. But everything depends upon, you know, what you actually want to do. You know, what kind of imagery you are using. And what is the intention behind, you know, those imagery. And how well, you know, you can, you know, actually articulate, you know, those intentions. And as a painter, you don't deal with time. You are dealing with space only. It could be a medium which frees you from your own, what you call, confinements. So in my case, you know, I don't feel that. So I'm quite happy and comfortable and quite, okay with what the two-dimensional surface. If you feel comfortable, well and good. If you don't, stick to what you do. Yeah.